Father, we appreciate, we give you praise for another time in your presence. Thank you for your loving kindness. Thank you for the grace of life, for your gift to us, O Lord, and for all you continue to do in our lives, in the life of our families, in the life of your children. Be thou exalted, be thou glorified. Even as we learn from your table today, teach us to break your word for us. Make your light shine upon us and be gracious to us. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Beloved, we thank God for being able to come your way again today. It's a prayer that God, the Father of grace, peace, and blessing, will keep us, and that His desire towards us and towards all His faithful people of blessing will be our portion now and always, in Jesus' name. Amen. Today we are speaking on what we have titled, "The Lord Bless You and Keep You." The Lord bless you and keep you. To help us in this conversation, we're going to be reading from Numbers chapter 6, from verse 22 to 27. Numbers chapter 6, from verse 22 to 27. That scripture records said, "And the Lord spake to Moses, saying, Speak to Aaron and his sons, saying, This is the way you shall bless the children of Israel. Say to them, The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace." Verse 27 says, "So they shall put My name on the children of Israel, and I will bless them." Hallelujah. Beloved, God has given one important ministry, okay, to the priest. And that important ministry included that they would offer sacrifices and lead the people in worship. But at the heart of that ministry was that they will bless the people, like we have read in this scripture in Numbers chapter 6. Hallelujah. And you see, in concluding in verse 27, he said this. He said, "They will put My name on the Israelites and I will bless them." Hallelujah. "They will put My name on the Israelites and they will bless them." God will bless you and keep you. Now, if you go to the book of Leviticus, scripture breaks down how this blessing was to be given, or it was to be provided to the people. That the priests were to put their hands over their heads when they are uttering these blessings, to signify or to show that this was God directly blessing His people. So when we say the Lord bless you, hallelujah, what do we mean? It's, you know, scripture looks at it by talking about, you know, from the Hebrew word of the word bless, it talks of unbended knees. Okay, it describes a servant kneeling out of respect for his master, or a lover kneeling to ask his beloved for a hand in marriage. Now, this is a wonderful moment and a wonderful expression of what it means for God to bless us. To bless us, it means that God comes in His majesty. He comes to honor us. God is offering to come to His people on bended knees. That is, to serve them, to love them, to share Himself with them. That is God blessing you. Hallelujah. So, you see, it's a beautiful a scripture that expresses the depth of God's love for us, which is at service. Praise God. Now, the second part of that phrase is, "and keep us." What do we think that means? Hallelujah. So, from the Hebrew word of to keep, it means, you know, it refers to how shepherds used to use thorn bushes to provide or build a protective enclosure for their sheep. So it means, therefore, that to keep literally means to build a hedge around us. So God, in keeping us, means that He is protecting us from harm, putting around us and our life a sort of fence to keep out enemies that will snatch away the blessings that God has given to you and has given to me. Now, how staggering that thought is, that God, the Supreme Father of heaven and earth, who dwells in eternity, the creator and ruler of all things, will get down on one knee, hallelujah, as a servant to you know to serve people like me and you, even as sinful and as rebellious that we are, that He would take the trouble to build a protective edge around us. What a wondrous story. And you see, there are three levels to the blessing. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine on you and be gracious unto you. Hallelujah. It's a significant statement because it tells us that it talks about, you know, strengthening the threefold ministry and going back to the Trinity. It's just like the holy, holy, holy prayer that comes, you know, that angelic song in Isaiah chapter 6. It's a significant statement of God's loving kindness and establishment of the blessed Trinity in our life. I don't know about you, but I want to enjoy the blessing of this awesome God and being kept under Him. But this can only happen for those that have a relationship with Him, that have made this God their Father and the center of your life. So if you want to reconcile your relationship with God, call the numbers on the screen and there will be someone to pray for you, to walk with you and lead you to this awesome Jesus that loves you and want to share His life, His story with you. Don't forget that you can get other copies of our previous editions at our YouTube channel at ROD space ROCCG. Hallelujah. God bless you and keep you.